So you want to edit a YouTube video from start to finish, but where the heck do you start? And where do you end? Well, my friends, have no fear, because today I'm going to teach you my 6-step process that I've been using in my business for over 2 years to not only edit my YouTube videos, but also our clients' videos. So you don't want to miss this. Also, this video is sponsored by ArtGrid, officially making me a real YouTuber.
How high class, we got a sponsor.
So if you're in need of any cinematic high quality stock footage, then this is the place to go. So click the link in the description to get 2 free months on your plan. Now, first up, what editing software do you even use? Well, personally, if you've been around for a while now, which I'm assuming some of you have, I've been using DaVinci Resolve. Before that, I was using Premiere Pro for over 2 years, but actually switched from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve. And there's a lot of reasons why I did that, but you know, for me, DaVinci Resolve, definitely an awesome program. And plus, DaVinci Resolve has a free version. So if you are totally new to content creation, then DaVinci Resolve free version is definitely one of the best free editing softwares out there. But that is my personal opinion, and whatever you decide to use, whether it's DaVinci Resolve, Premiere Pro, Final Cut, or any other editing software, this 6-step process will totally work for you. But first, if you're new here, my name is Billy Repka, and I make weekly videos all about teaching you to become a better video editor. So if you want to level up your editing skills, click the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on anything. So my first step in this whole thing is called the setup. This is where you're gonna organize your files by, you know, having some type of like file structure. Maybe it's just A roll, B roll, and audio, right? It could be something super simple like that. You just wanna have an idea of where you're putting your files. Then you'll import stuff into your editing software, and then you'll sync up any external audio and video or multicam stuff, because right now we're just setting stuff up so you can come in and edit up your video without having to run around and do a ton of different things. Because quite honestly, I did that for way too long and I wasted so much time. So once we've set everything up, we're gonna move on to our step 2, which is called the rough cut. This is where you're gonna cut out all of those long pauses, the blank stares, your boring stuff, and your multiple takes. Now, you don't have to have super tight cuts because it's supposed to be a quick overview, and I normally go through this step at 2x speed. And if you wanna know how to do that, I put out a video last week with all of my personal shortcuts, so you can check that out. Anyway, this step is super important because overall, it gives you an overview of what you're gonna be working on. You can separate the good clips from the bad clips. I personally just get rid of them because I know that I'm not gonna need it, because I put a lot of time planning these videos out and know what they're gonna look like before I hit record. Now, if you're getting stuck because you have 2 or 3 versions of the same thing and you can't make your mind up on what is best, what you can do is pull those onto the video track above and just come back later and go through it to see what sounds best. Anyway, if you're getting value from this video and you want me to make more like it, then click the like button and maybe even a subscribe button if you want to stick around for a while. Anyway, our 3rd step is the polished cut. Now, this is where we're going to tighten up our cuts, we're going to refine the story, and you're gonna play with the structure and timing, because we really wanna make sure that we're getting our video structure down. Now, typically I'm gonna go through this at normal speed and watch the video, move things around if I have to, refine my cuts, because in the last step, we weren't thinking about how it sounds and flows. We were thinking about getting our clips and getting rid of all of those dead space and things like that. This is where we're gonna take our time, refine our story, and really make sure that our video flows well. And a quick pro tip is, as you're going through the video, take time to envision how the whole video is gonna go. Mark out the areas you want to place B-roll, effects, texts, or pictures. This is gonna help you to go through your video a lot faster, and it'll actually speed up the next step a bit, which is number 4, add supporting elements. And supporting elements are just that. They help to support your main content, and without them, your video wouldn't have a leg to stand on, and it would be completely bland and not engaging. So what are supporting elements? Supporting elements are music, their effects, their titles, transitions, and most importantly, to really hold people's attention and drive up engagement, B-roll. Now, there's really 2 ways to get B-roll. You can shoot it yourself, or if you don't have the time, equipment, or you can't go to that location, then stock footage is a fast and easy way to get you high quality footage for your videos. And one that I've personally and professionally been using for almost 2 years now is ArtGrid. They have thousands of clips that are super high quality and cinematic, and they make it super easy to find specific things. Like if I want something that's slow-mo or super slow-mo or a locked off shot, I can just choose the types of video that I wanna see. And because of that, if you've watched any of my videos over the last year and a half, you've probably seen a lot of their footage and not even known it. And honestly, it saved me a ton of time, especially when I'm working with clients, because if they didn't get B-roll or they didn't know to get B-roll, I can just get on there and find footage that'll work with their video. And right now you can get 2 extra free months on your subscription if you use my link down below. So when you're adding these supporting elements, it is super important that you do one of these things at a time. So you'll add all of your titles, then you add all of your effects, then all of your B-roll. Now, the reason we're doing this is because it is super inefficient to be switching back and forth from adding titles to B-roll to effects to doing that. Like you're switching so many different gears that you really can't focus on just doing everything all at once. Over time, I've just found that it makes things a lot faster. So now on to our fifth step, which is finalize. Now in this step, what we're gonna focus on is doing our sound design, which is ultimately just adding sound effects to things like titles, transitions, and other effects, because it'll help your video from not sounding flat. And also in this step, we wanna mix our audio, because you don't want your music to be louder than your voice, unless you do. But odds are you don't. So as a general guide, I try to keep my voice between -2 decibels and -6. And then the background music, keep it between -26 and -32 decibels. And then sound effects really should not be punching you in the eardrum. They should be very subtle and almost unnoticeable. So as a very loose general rule, I keep them anywhere from -9 decibels to -20. And then after mixing your audio, you can color correct your footage, which is pretty much just balancing out the colors, making sure that the whites appear white and that the blacks appear black, and then making sure everything isn't blown out. So ultimately, it just looks natural. Now, unfortunately, I can't go over all the different things with color correction because this video would be very long. So there are other videos out there that have a ton of help of how to do color grading in whatever software you're using. All right, once you've done your setup, your rough cut, your polished cut, you've added your supporting elements, and you've finalized all of the different things like color correction and sound design, we move on to our sixth and final step, which is reviewing and rendering. This right here is as simple as it sounds. You're gonna go back and watch the video from beginning to end. You can adjust stuff if you need to, because you know there's always little tweaks you can make. But in general, if you've made it this far, you probably have a pretty solid video on your hand. Then once you're happy with it, go ahead, render it out, and then watch your final video before you upload it anywhere, because there's been a few times where I've had some weird glitches that were not in the editing software, but were a result of the rendering. So just trust me on this, especially when you're working with clients, watch it first. Anyway, was this a helpful video for you guys? Let me know in the comments below. And also, if you're looking to increase your engagement and up your video quality, then make sure to check out ArtGrid and find thousands of high quality clips filmed with the industry's best cameras. So click the link down below and get 2 extra months on your plan. Anyway, if you want more videos like this, click on the top for all of my video editing tutorials, or click on the bottom for a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.